Hello, Patrick Walchuk with an update on multifamily investment properties in Ottawa to the end of October. I'll give you the statistical update on these buildings, and then I'll take you through some numbers that I crunched on two different types of buildings to show you what investors are getting as a return on the properties they purchase. So getting right into it, for the smaller buildings year to date, from January to October 31st, we've had 109 of these properties sell this year, which is an increase of 14%. The average price of one of these properties, this is the 2 to 4 unit buildings, is now $637,000, and that's an increase of 4% over last year. The smaller buildings, again, the 2 to 4 units, the sellers are getting 96% of their list price, and they're selling in an average of 61 days, which is up from 51 days last year. Now, we have a completely different story when we're talking about the larger buildings, and I have not seen these kind of numbers in years, and unfortunately it's been very consistent this year. So when we're talking about the 5-unit plus buildings, we've only had 15 sales this year compared to 25 last year, which is a decrease of 40%. Pretty significant, even if it is just 10 buildings. The average price of one of these buildings is basically flat with last year at $1.4 million. And owners are getting 94% of their list price, and they're taking on average 83 days to sell, which is longer than last year when they were taking 68 days to sell. Now, when we look at the specifics of a couple of buildings, and I'm hoping this will help you understand what investors are getting, what we've done this month is selected two different properties. This Centertown 8-unit building is basically a brand new building. There's tenants in it, but it was just finished being constructed this year. And we have a property, an older building in Castle Heights, which is in the east end of Ottawa, east of Vanier. And this is a 3-unit building. So depending on your pocketbook, let's quickly go through the numbers on these properties. So for the Centertown property, the new building, that sold for a little over $3 million. The scheduled rental income, that's the most amount of money that a property could possibly make, was $192,000. When you deduct 4% for vacancy and bad debt, you come up with the effective rental income, and that building had an ERI of $184,320. The total operating expenses were quite low at $41,792. Because it is a new building, you're not going to have the deferred maintenance and the infrastructure costs that you would typically associate with an older building. So that's quite low. Consequently, your net operating income is on the higher side of $142,528. That gives you a really remarkable cap rate for this location, and that is 4.6%. The operating expense ratio is almost 23%, which is extremely low, as you would expect. Again, a new building, right? So you don't have those operating expenses. The cash flow on that, now what you need to understand is I did the calculation as though you're an investor and you're buying this property with a 35% down payment, because that's what you typically need to produce a positive cash flow, and it's typically what a bank will request of you. Oh, and by the way, I just want to stop here for a second. I get it from investors all the time. Hey, I only need to put 20% down. Don't tell me I need 30 or 35% down. Well, I ain't telling you that. That's what a bank's going to tell you, because it doesn't matter what the federal government regulations are at 20% for an investment property. A bank is risk adverse, and they will only lend you money if you're looking at a positive cash flow on it, unless you got really, really deep pockets. So 35% is your rule of thumb, okay? Now, when you do that, you have a positive cash flow of $29,020. That means you've put down 35%, and based on your ADS, your annual debt service, which is your mortgage amount, so when you pay your mortgage off, this is the amount of money you got coming into your pocket every year. So the return on your investment is 2.7%. That's not bad. That's not bad. Compare that to what you can get on a GIC or anything like that. So that's property number one. Now we'll just skim through this one here. Obviously a completely different price range. The scheduled rental income is about $39,000. You knock off 4% for vacancy and bad debt, you're looking at close to $38,000 on this property. The operating expenses are a little over $14,000. And your net operating income is $23,500 and change. Now, it's got a cap of 3.7%. For Ottawa, that's really not bad. And the operating expense ratio is 38%. Again, in Ottawa, that is average to good. But you can see, you know, being an older building, it's not as good as a brand new shiny building at 22.7%. So 38%, that's quite good. The purchaser of this property with 35% down payment is going to see a pretty small return on their investment, though, of only $625 annually. And what that means is that he's getting a return on his investment of 0.3%. That's 0.3%. Pretty low, but welcome to Ottawa. Thanks for watching. Oh, by the way, one thing if I just remind you of is that if you want to know how to make these calculations, simply go to our website and click on the multifamily tab, and we have a whole bunch of great information, including how to do these calculations. Thank you.